Well, welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Replace fear with love. The human mind is like a fertile ground where seeds are continually being planted. When you're impeccable with your word, your mind is no longer a fertile ground for the words that come from fear. Your mind is only fertile for the words that come from love. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 57. NASDAQ up 34. S&P's up 8.5. Gold contract up $1.80. Trading at $14.95 an ounce. Silver up 13 cents. $17.56 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 61 cents. $53.97 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You got the 10-year down 2 ticks. 129.29, 30-year off 2 at 160.07, and King Dollar. King Dollar down 388 ticks, trading 97.613. The Euro is at 111. The Yen is at trading at 108. And the Pound is at 128 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, so bring up the SPY first. What you're going to see out here, you're going to... basically a sideways day out here. You're up $1.09 in the SPY. You get over the highs of Tuesday. The highs of Tuesday right now, 299.70. You're at 299.49. We had made it up to 300. Bottom line, you're still dying on the vine volume-wise. We'll see whether it's going to hold the price as we come into the close out here. NDX 100. We take a look at the NDX 100, the 3Qs. 3Qs gave it up pretty early this morning, actually. Well, we go take a look at this. And so we get with the 3Qs out here. It's up 51 cents right now. We've done 14 million shares. The benchmark out here is going to be the Tuesday high, which is 193.97, 23,000 contracts, I mean shares. Now, the amazing thing about the Qs, folks, is this, is that the contraction of volume is not really out there, but it's going to be really hard that we can actually contract from yesterday, but it looks like we're going to. So, first off, we're going into the downdraft from August 1st, which has 63 million shares. First time we get up there, you know, we hit them with 28 million. That was on September 12th. Next time was on Tuesday, and we did 23 million. Yesterday, you did 20 million. And the bottom line is, if we do less than 23 million today and we fail holding price of 193.97, which I expect we're going to, that's a monster failure in price and volume, because it's hard to comprehend that the volume could contract that much more again. But guess what? That's how this is setting up. We're going to take a look at the small caps out here. Small caps, the IWM. The IWM is up $1.80. You've done 8 million shares. Anemic. And this is a trip in itself. You got anemic volume, but they're pricing it. That's the real bottom line. They're not buying the Qs. They're buying the small caps out here today. That being said, we'll see if it can, in fact, hold the 153.35 coming into the close, because that's what it's testing out here today. That was the downdraft when the IWM actually got smoked and went from 153 to 148 in about a heartbeat. Gold and silver. Gold and silver, bottom line, you get a little bit out here today. Nothing really heavy. You're up $1.70, 291,000 contracts traded. What I want to see inside that gold market right now is a sign of strength. Silver, same type of setup in silver. If we do go over to the dollar, bottom line, inside the dollar, different animal. This thing has came down fast and furious, came down with conviction today. We've gone from a price point of 98.113 to 97.49, and this looks like it's making its way back down to the lower end of the consolidation, which is that 95.843. If we go over and we take a look at the pound, this is going to be all about. What's going to get really interesting here now, too, folks, is that it looks like they're going to finally get a deal done in Brexit. And if that's the case, you're going to see both the pound as well as the euro continue higher. The pound has gone from a price point of 122 to 128 in about 7 days. The way this is set up right now, 131 is game pretty quickly. And, yeah, 133, actually. And we are inside the higher range now. So, you know, once you get to 133, bottom line, you're getting juice at 133. You can be up at 142 in about a heartbeat. And, of course, both of these currencies have got smoked in a huge way. Euro, same setup in the euro, did with the euro. Right now we're trading 111. That's in the larger range also. That came off the lows about 3 weeks ago. And that's also in the higher range. That's saying the euro wants to run up into this 114 area. We go down and we take a look at the yen. The yen is teetering, looking to basically make a turn. But the bottom line is, and when I say make a turn, I'm talking about make a turn downtown again, get stronger. But that's thus far, you know, it hasn't rejected these highs up here. We got to 108.94 today. The high of Tuesday was 108.94. Now, you've given it up. I mean, the bottom line is it's given up in price since then. But I want to see that yen get away from these the 109 area in general. Why? Because if it did break that area, that would put some pressure inside the gold market. When I look at the gold equities, it's not even close. They want higher price. But guess what? We want to keep our eye on that yen. IBM. IBM came out with numbers. They, bottom line, are getting smoked once again. The stock's down from 2015, from $215. They're at 134 right now. And this is barreling down with some monster volume. You get 13 million shares being traded. You get a high volume low that's laying out here. It looks like it wants to get tested again. That thing is laying out here at all of 94 to 69. You know, first it'd have to, of course, attack the 105 area. But there's problems in paradise out here inside good old IBM. They're still contracting. You know, they still have free cash flow. The free cash flow is not bad, about $12 billion. But bottom line is that as you keep contracting quarter after quarter after quarter, it makes a huge difference. There's no two ways about that. We got to take a look at some of the higher volume equities. Oh, Netflix. Let's go to Netflix. NFLX. Netflix came out with numbers. They had big numbers overseas, not great numbers in the U.S. That being said, they're up $8.90. They get volume behind the move. So this is going to try to bust into this 320 area. Right now, you're at 295. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Stay right there, folks. Going to come back with our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. We're going to be talking the markets.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here.